A lot of people come into the yoga practice, especially at home, and they ask, I don't really know how to do it safely. Well, the funny thing is every part of our life, including our yoga practice, we have to take risk. There's actually no choice. You can't control the future. So basically, you're always at risk. At risk of what? Hurting yourself, at risk of doing something wrong. There's a great Zen saying that in your practice, it's one continuous mistake. I want to tell people, in your yoga practice, you always have to take a risk. You can take a calculated risk, though. You don't have to be crazy. And how can you feel when the risk is too great? What you can do again is listen to the breath. If your breath is getting too tense, if you shut down your eyes and your jaw, like locking up and forcing things, that's obviously telling you that you're going into something without any observation. So if you're going to take a risk, you're going to want to have the facilities of observation. It's like going down a river. If you're going to go down a waterfall, you're going to probably want to climb up the cliff and just look at the water that you're going to run. You're going to want to observe and see so you can maybe plan out a course that's going to move you through maybe a more dangerous situation. When you're doing a difficult yoga pose, it's the same thing. You don't want to just rush into it and say, I'm going to jump off the cliff. You want to look at it and ask, how can I build up to this pose? How can I be creative every day doing a little bit movement towards this pose? Using props so that you can facilitate doing the pose without necessarily holding onto your foot or being that deeply into it. People push too far too fast. What we really need to do is take risk, but little steps at a time. This is the way. That doesn't ensure safety, but it really is a gentle, peaceful way of moving in the world, of moving in our yoga practice.